नगाल प्रसन्न है। सो आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर मणिकंदन सर फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिलीवर ए प्रेजेंटेशन अबाउट ऑप्टिकल मेजरमेंट टेक्नोलॉजीज इन 3D स्कैनर। माई सेल्फ आई एम गुणशीलन वर्किंग एज अ सीनियर प्रोजेक्ट इंजीनियर एट PSG टाइको कोर एट PSG कॉलेज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी। स्ट्रेट वे विल गो टू द प्रेजेंटेशन। टाइफो कोर सेंटर, दिस सेंटर वॉज एस्टाब्लिश एट द ईयर ऑफ 2001। दिस सेंटर हैज फुल फ्लेज्ड 3D प्रिंटिंग, री इंजीनियरिंग एंड वैक्यूम कास्टिंग फैसिलिटी। द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस सेंटर इज टू सपोर्ट द इंडस्ट्रीज फॉर द न्यू प्रोडक्ट डिजाइन डेवलपमेंट एक्टिविटीज इन प्रोडक्ट डिजाइन एंड ऑप्टिमाइजेशन प्रोजेक्ट। We are also conducting workshops for students and conducting short-term courses for the students, engineers, and various institutions. We are serving industries like automobile, aerospace, government labs, and agriculture centers and R&D labs. Everything. More than 100 industries are taking service from our center. The facilities available at PSG Typho Course Center. We have major technologies like plastic additive manufacturing technology and re-engineering technologies and additive vacuum casting technology. In plastic additive manufacturing, we have three major technologies like stereolithography, selective laser sintering, and fused deposition molding. We have four different kind of machines. This rapid prototyping is nothing but a conversion of 3D CAD model into physical product. It's achieved by a layer by layer additive manufacturing process. In this center, we have three major technologies like stereolithography. This stereolithography, we have Viper SI2 machine from 3D System Germany. This is a small build platform size machine. It's a 250 mm cubic size machine. We have two material options like ABS plastic and polycarbonate. Next one, we have fused deposition molding machine. This is a huge build platform size machine. Up to 1 cubic meter part we can build by this machine. 914 mm by 660 mm by 914 mm. We can build up to 1 cubic meter part. Five different kind of material options are available in this machine: ABS plastic, polycarbonate, PC-ABS, ULTEM, and PPSO. For the general kind of application, normally the customers require ABS and polycarbonate material. For the high temperature requirement or high strength requirement, customer will require ULTEM and PPSO material. We have one more technology machine called selective laser sintering technology. In this selective laser sintering technology, we have Synthestation 2500 plus machine from 3D System Germany. So this machine has a polyamide powder. It's equivalent to nylon material. It has some flexibility in the output. So we have three major technologies. And one more thing, we have a bigger size SLE machine called ISLE 650 Pro. The machine from Shining 3D, China. So it's a huge build platform size, 650 by 650 by 400 mm. So we can build a bigger size part in SLA technology. So the output, it has a smooth surface finish. We can use it for the investment casting pattern also. We can build by this machine. And one more thing, we have re-engineering technology. This re-engineering is nothing but the conversion of physical product into the 3D CAD file by using it with help of the 3D scanner. In this 3D scanner, we have advanced level of scanner like GAM ADAS 2M scanner. It's a blue light technology scanner from GAM Germany. One more thing, we have rapid tooling technology. In case the customer required minimum number of components like 20 numbers or 50 numbers, instead of going to the injection molding process, it consumes more time and consumes more cost. With the help of this vacuum casting technology, we can minimum number of minimum job production like 50 numbers, 100 numbers, easily we can produce. For this vacuum casting technology, we are using MK technology, German machine. The outputs like material like polyurethane, ABS kind of plastics. Next, what is scanning? Scanning is a collection of data of the undefined three-dimensional surface. So nowadays, many companies are using this scanner to get the 3D CAD data for the real products to get the real parts to capture the lost design. In case they lost the design of the original product, sometimes they want to update their existing product. Like sometimes in case the pump industry, they want to increase the efficiency of the pump. So they need to change the vein angle or the thickness or something. So for that, they need a 3D CAD file. From that onwards, they can edit the CAD file into various parameters. Then they'll go further. They'll try with some other method, in the ANSYS method, then prototype method. Then they'll go for the mass production. They'll achieve it. So update their existing product or make new ones. So for that kind, we need the 3D scanning method to create the 3D CAD file. And it's used in the various fields like tool and die industries, mold making industries, press tool industry, aerospace industry. Nowadays, medical industry also using this facility to develop the 3D CAD file. Okay. What is 3D scanning? 3D scanning is a non-conduct or non-destructive technology. By using this laser light source or laser line source to get the 3D dimensional data. So the output in the form of a point cloud. It's like a millions of point cloud from the output. So from this output, we'll take the sections, then draw the curves, then we create the 3D CAD file. Okay. The laser scanning, we can explain as capture a physical object as an exact size and shape with the help of the 3D scanner. It can, by using the conventional method like a vernier or caliper or some kind of conventional method, we can measure only the particular profile or particular dimensions only we can measure. But with the help of the 3D scanner, we can measure the fine details also. And also the accurate one, it's, compared with the conventional one, it's accurate one. So we get the full complete data of the physical object. So from that, we can use it for the 3D reverse engineering purpose, or we can use it for the 3D inspection, whatever the purpose, we can solve it. That is it. So the main purpose of the 3D scanner, we can use it for the 3D inspection. So from that point, with the help of the 3D scanner, we can get the whole point cloud data. From the point cloud, we can compare it with the original CAD file. We can use it for the inspection purpose. So we'll get the overall data of the component. So we can adjust the parameter. So will produce a good quality output from the machine. Okay. Data acquisition via the scanning, 3D scanning process. The 3D scanning process, initially we keep the component on the 3D based digitizer. Then using this 3D scanner, this 3D scanner has one is a projector and next one is a 3D camera. This projector will project the light source, then the camera will capture the images. The series of images taken, then clubbed together, finally we'll get the whole point cloud data. So this data has a, each point has a XYZ dimension. So from this, we can use it for the 3D measurement purpose, or we can create the 3D CAD file, whatever we can produce. This 3D CAD data, we can use it for the mainly it can use for the two purpose. One is for the re-engineering and next one is for the inspection. The re-engineering is nothing but by using the 3D scanner, we can produce we'll get a whole point cloud data. This whole point cloud data will take into the specialized software like GeoMagic or Polyworks something, then taking sections on the based on the profile or based on the feature, we'll take a section, then based on the section we can draw the curve. Like in AutoCAD, we'll pick a 3 point to draw the curve and 2 point to draw the line like that. So based on the profile, we'll take a section and draw the curves. By using that curves to develop the 3D CAD file, like by using surface method or solid method to create a 3D CAD file. This 3D CAD file, we can export into various formats like IGS, STEP, Parasolid, whatever the format we require, we can export it. That data, they can use it for the injection molding die or pattern development, whatever the purpose, or we can input into the 3D printing machine to create a physical prototype also we can produce. So whatever the purpose, we can solve. Next one is a 3D inspection. This 3D inspection, from the 3D scanning process, we'll get the whole point cloud data of the component, the whole point cloud data. This whole point cloud data, we club to measure with the nominal CAD file. We can measure the, we can see the deviation in a color map. In case it's a nominal one, it's in a white, it's in a green color. In case it has some shrinkage, it's in a blue color. Sometimes the color mapping shows what where is the shrinkage happen, where is the shift mark happen. Based on that, the die maker or tool maker or pattern maker, they'll adjust the runner dimension or feed dimension, whatever the parameter, they'll adjust. So it will give the complete idea of the product, output product. So based on that, we can adjust the die or pattern something. So it's called the first article inspection. So next, based on the correction itself, we can get the good quality output from the next project onwards. So that idea we can get it from the 3D inspection. Okay. This 3D scanning process classified into two types. One is a contact method, another one is a non-contact method. This contact method is like a touch probe ruby rod, like a CMM machine. It will move over the component, then we'll get the point cloud data. We'll see it later. Next one is a non-contact method. This non-contact method uses a laser light source. This laser light source either white light or blue light scanner. This it projecting a series of pattern of lights onto the object to scan. We'll get the point cloud data. It has a two camera. One is a projector. Next one is a camera. It's a two camera system or single camera system. So this projector will project a series of stripes, pattern of lights on the component. Then this camera will capture the images. Basically, it works on the principle of triangulation method. We know the distance between the projector and the camera. We know the distance between the projector to the object to scan. Then only thing is the reflecting angle we can calculate. So based on this, we'll get the XYZ dimension. So each the stripes will help to get the whole complete detail of the component. So we'll get a complete detail. So each and every point has a millions of points. So this whole point cloud data, we can take it into 3D reverse engineering process. This is one of the method. It's a structural light or blue light scanner. The measurement principle of structural light is based on the defecting deformation of the pattern of light projected on the surface of the object. Initially, this projector will project a series of pattern of lights onto the object. Based on the component, this pattern of stripes pattern will deflect. This camera will capture that image. So either we can rotate the camera or we can rotate the object. So we'll get the whole point cloud based on that. So this camera will capture the distance between the object to the camera, or then the reflecting angle it will calculate. So finally we'll get the millions of points according to that. So displacement of stripes allows for a exact retrieval of the 3D coordinates of any surface detail. So it will be helpful to get the whole complete detail of the physical component. This structural light scanner ideal for scanning the objects with from car into aircraft structure, we can scan the small components like screws, nuts, everything we can scan it. And also medium components like engineering components like die pattern or something, we can scan it. The large components like statues, everything, bus, aircraft, we can scan it with the help of the 3D light scanner. So complex surface is not a matter for this scanner. So any kind of complexity, we can scan it. So the highly fine details, minimum 0.3 mm, 0.5 mm thickness of wall and the profiles, holes, everything we can get it with the help of the 3D scanner. And also it's a non-contact method. So it's highly helpful for the customer to get the whole point cloud data. Next one is a laser scanner. This laser scanner based on the principle of triangulation method. Instead of projecting the series of stripes onto the object, it will project only the laser line or the point. Only it will project point or line onto the object, then capturing the reflection with the sensor. Okay, we know the distance between the object to the laser source to the camera, and also we know the distance between the laser source to the object. So the reflection angle, calculating the reflection angle of the laser light, we'll get the point measurement. So with the help of this, we'll get the whole point cloud data. The arm scanner works on the principle of laser scanner. Okay. The reason for the re-engineering. The re-engineering makes the design process much easier by existing knowledge of building it. So from the scratch is like a pencil drawing, draw pencil sketches, then take into the AutoCAD drawing, then take into the 3D modeling software, then start from the 3D modeling. It takes so much time. With the help of this 3D scanner, instead of starting from the scratch, we can start from the existing product. So we scan the existing product, then we get the whole point cloud data. From that, we can create an original CAD file, or we can modify the original CAD file. According to that, we can go for the mass production process or production process, we'll get a physical product. So that is the idea. So this 3D scanning process to help to improving or changing the design of existing products. And also, in case the electronic industry, like electronic enclosure or assembly line, it will help to design a component or sometimes enclosure or something. So scan the entire component, entire assembly, then create according to that assembly, where it going to fit, where it going to assembly. According to that, we can design a particular product. So it will helpful. And also it will helpful for the repairing or worn out product. In case the turbine blades, it get damaged or it worn out. So we can scan the turbine blade, then we can get the worn out area or breakout area. From that itself, we can create a turbine blade. So it will give the idea of the worn out or damaged area. So based on the CAD file, we can eliminate, close that worn out area. The organic shapes or bionic shapes or complex surface, whatever the surface, we can scan with the help of this 3D scanner. So it will highly helpful for the customers to create the 3D CAD file. Okay. The conventional method and compared with the 3D light scanner, the comparison. So in the conventional method, at particular time, it takes one measurements only. At particular time, it's a very time consuming. So in case if you are measuring the distance, we can measure only that distance. And next time we are going to measure the dial gauge or diameter or something. So it takes so much time. But this help of 3D scanner, we can scan the entire component within a hour or within a half hour. So we'll get a whole point cloud data. So from the point cloud data, we can measure whatever the dimension we require, or we can create a 3D CAD model, then whatever the process, we can take it. So it's very time consuming, EPCM. And next one is a limitation. The conventional method has some limitation. The limited dimension only we can measure it. So, but this kind of 3D scan, we can measure whatever the shapes, whatever the curve or whatever the detail, we can measure it, we can draw it. So it's a very versatile one. And also the human involvement, it takes into, it's not very accurate one. So it has some limitation and also it has some problem. But in this kind of non-contact method, we will get a whole point cloud data. It's a high accurate data. The whole the structural light scanner has accuracy of 10 to 15 microns per meter. So we'll get the whole complete detail of the component, and also it's a very accurate one. And also this conventional method has some bottlenecks. So it's a time consuming, and also it's a very slower process. Once the designer, once a measurement QC person will measure the whole dimension, then he'll draw the profile, then he'll measure the dimension. Next, he'll give it to the engineer, then he'll draw the AutoCAD dimension. Then we'll take into the designer to draw the 3D CAD file. It takes so much time. But this 3D scanning process, and the person itself, he scan the entire component, then he'll get the whole point cloud data, then he'll take into the 3D modeling software, then he'll take its sections and draw the curve, then he'll create the 3D CAD file. So it minimizes the bottlenecks. And also this conventional method has limited intelligence. It can't take too many measurements within a time or constraint. But this 3D scanning process, it get collecting whole complete detail of the component. So it's more precise also. The only advantage of this conventional method is inexpensive. So it's very cost effective one. But this structural light scanner has some limitations. So that one is it's a costly scanner. Okay. Earlier we used this scanner in our center. This is a Renesas Cyclones 3D scanner. It's a contact method scanner. This scanner we used from 2001 to 2014. It has the measurement dimension is 600 by 400 by 300. It has some limitations. I'll explain that. So from Renesas we bought this scanner. It's a touch probe rod, ruby rod will be there. Then this ruby rod will move over the component. Then we'll generate the 3D point cloud data. From the point cloud data, we can develop the 3D cloud. It's a more time consuming. So for this kind of impeller, it will take 4 hours or 5 hours time to take the scan to get the whole point cloud data. Nowadays, we are using this kind of structure light scanner. Half an hour to 1 hour, we'll scan the entire thing. The contact method scanner, it has some limitation and advantages. What is the advantage means? The environmental condition is not matter for this camera. So, and also it's suited for the simple structures like cover or some kind of blade, something we can measure with the help of this scanner. And also it's it has some accuracy level also. From micron level, we can measure it. So, and also no need to spray on the component to, and also no need of a reference marker or something. It's no need. That is the advantage. The main disadvantage is it's a wear for a probe. Sometimes the corner area, this ruby rod probe is a diametrical shape. So it's move over the corner shape. So the exact corner, radius we can't measure. So based on the ball radius only we will measure. So that is a disadvantage. And also the rubber like component we can't measure with this kind of contact method scanner, because the probe pressure will act on the component. And also limited measuring range only it's available. Some like 500 mm or 600 mm only we can measure with this kind of scanner. And also it unable to capture the whole point cloud data of the components. So that is the main disadvantage of this scanner. So we bought this kind of 3D light scanner. So it's a very advanced level of scanner. The process involved in this re-engineering process. By using this 3D scanner, we'll get the whole point cloud data of the component, like millions of points in this component. And take into the software like geometric, CATIAS, all those same thing. So it will take, based on the profile or feature, we'll take a number of sections. So drawing the curves according to that section, then taking to the software, then creating surface model with the help of the surface modeling method or the solid modeling method, then create the 3D CAD. It's a simple process only. The software involved in this 3D scanning process, there is 3D scanning process for the reverse engineering purpose, from the point cloud data to create a 3D CAD file. Various software is involved in this software, mainly for the reverse engineering purpose. We are using Geomagic DesignX. Customers are using Space Climb software or Polywork software, something. For the inspection purpose, for merge with the original part of data with the 3D CAD file, we are using the GOM inspection software and Geomagic control software. That is the best software to going for the 3D inspection process. For the scientific measurement like bone growth or muscle growth or tissue growth, the people are using Rhino software. That is highly helpful for the customers. This is a scanner we are using in our center. That is GAMADAS 2M scanner. It's a ready-to scan system and it's a highly compact one. So it's a lightweight technology. It has a two camera and one projector system. It's a blue light technology. Instead of using this white light scanner, we are using blue light scanner. So white light scanner has some disadvantage because the ampere light distraction will be there in the white light scanner. So the output of data, it has some noise and unwanted data in this output data in by using white light scanner. So we bought this blue light technology scanner. So it's a highly efficient one and also ready to scan system. So it eliminates all the noises. Then we'll get the whole point cloud data and good accurate and precise data. We'll get it from this kind of scanner. It's a blue light technology, non-contact method, and uses a blue light source, projecting fringe pattern onto the object, then taking series of images. This sensor it will convert these 2D images into the 3D point cloud data with the help of this software. The advantages of this ADAS combat scan is used for the 3D measurement and 3D inspection. The output from this 3D scanner, we use it for the 3D measurement or 3D inspection. It's a blue light technology. It has a various scalable view. So we'll use two kind of lenses. For the minimum small kind of object, we are using the smaller lenses. It can scan from 30 mm component to 90 mm component. And also we are using medium level scanner lenses to scan the bigger objects. The scalable point of view, we can vary it. So that is the main advantage of this scanner. And also we can scan from the steel coin to the aircraft structure also, we can scan through this scanner. Technical details in this ADAMS comes. It's a 2 megapixel camera scanner. So we'll get a good accurate data. And also the measuring ranges from 35 to 30 into 1000 to 750 mm square area. The scale, the field of view, we can vary it. So for the signal shot, it will cover, normally it will cover 200 by 200 area. So in case we can rotate, either we can rotate the camera or either we can rotate the scanner to get the whole point cloud data. Principle of the scanning. So initially what we'll do, we'll spray a powder, chalk powder spray over the component, and we'll fix the reference markers in a zigzag manner over to the component. So these reference marker will help to the alignment of data in case we are scanning the top side of the component. Next time we are scanning the bottom side of the component. So for the alignment purpose, we are using this reference markers. Based on the common reference point, it will automatically align together. So finally, we'll get the whole point cloud data. That is the idea of this scanner. So initially, we'll fix the reference marker. Then the projector will project a series of fringe pattern over to the component. Finally, we'll get the camera will capture the images. Then these 2D images will convert to the 3D point cloud data. That is the idea. This point cloud data, we can use it for the various kind of purpose. The main purpose is the reverse engineering from the point cloud data to the 3D CAD file. We can export it to the IGSTEM format or STEP format or Parasolid format, whatever format we can export it. Next one is a quality control for the measurement purpose, only for the measurement, measuring the distance or measuring the diameter or measuring the curve or whatever, maybe we can use it. Next one is a 3D inspection, comparing with the original CAD file with the point cloud data. So we get the idea about the deviation mapping something. Next one is this point cloud data we can input into the 3D printing machine. Like in case if you are scanning the statues, scanning the entire statues, we'll get the point cloud data in a .stl format. This .stl format, we can input to the 3D printing machine. Then the 3D printing machine prints from the bottom layer to the top layer. Finally, we'll get the physical prototype. Okay. We can use it for this kind of purpose also. Mainly the industrial application, normally they'll use it for the main purpose for the reverse engineering from the point cloud data to the 3D CAD file. Next one is a scientific measurement in the tissues or tissue growth or bone growth or something. Next one is additive manufacturing or 3D printing. 3D visualization, how the product will be look like. So scanning the physical component, then making changes in the component, 3D CAD file, then finally look like how it will look like after the changes, so we can use it. Next one is an inspection, 3D inspection or 2D inspection, what are the purpose, we can use it. The advantages of ADAS Combat Scan 2M scanner is it's a fast data acquisition. So quickly we can scan the entire component. That is a and also no special fixtures are required. So like contact measurement, contact initial cyclone scanner, no need of any special fixtures to hold the component or rotate the component or something. So we can rotate either component or the scanner. We can get the whole point cloud data, and also it's easy to move the entire scanner or ready to scan system. So we'll get the good data, and also we can use take into wherever the places, then we can scan it. And also we can use it for small components also, we can scan it, and also medium sized component also we can scan it, and large size components also we can scan it with the help of this 3D scanner. For using this 3D scanner, some of the parameters we need to study. First one is the accuracy. What is the accuracy? The accuracy is where we are going to use this point cloud. In case the customer requires low accuracy data, only this like statues, so it requires less accuracy data. For this purpose, we can use either we can adjust the parameter to get the minimum number of points. So minimum number of points to get the whole complete data of the comp. So we can use it for that kind of purpose. In case the customer requires the full detail and also the accurate one detail, so that time we are adjusting the point spacing to get the whole point cloud data. We can use it for the 3D inspection or reverse engineering purpose to get the complete measurement. So that time we need to get the good quality data. Further, we use this scanner to get the good accurate data. Next one is a resolution. So minimum size, minimum shape, nominal size and nominal shape, the minimum profile. So no need to get the good resolution or high resolution data. It's a small diameter or small the medium diameter or the normal profile or the ribs or something. So no need to get the high resolution data. So based on that, we'll adjust the parameter. So sometimes the customer requires a high resolution data, like a medical scanner, some kind of tissues we are scanning, some kind of bone we are scanning, implant we are scanning. That time we need to get a good resolution scanner to get the whole point cloud data. Next one is a scan speed. In case scan speed is based on the scanner and also the person who was scanning, and also sometimes what are the purpose we are using to scan. Sometimes the stationary object we can scan at the lower speed, so there is no problem. Sometimes we are scanning the whole body or some physical, or so that time we need to scan faster. They'll move it accordingly. So based on that, we can adjust the scan speed. Re-engineering workflow. With the help of this 3D scanner, we'll get the whole point cloud data. That point cloud data, we can use it for the various purpose. How we going to do? So the re-engineering software, it will take into first initially what they'll do, various purpose, like in case for the 3D ANSYS simulation or analysis purpose, we can take this point cloud data into straight away, we can take into the analysis or simulation purpose, we can straight away we can take it. Sometimes for editing the CAD file or changing some dimensions in the CAD file, so for that we need to develop the parametric model. So for that various kind of software like SolidWorks or CATIA is there. So taking sections and taking to the software, then parametrically we can model the entire component. So based on that parametric model, we can adjust the curve dimension or profile dimension, everything we can adjust. Next one is the auto surfacing method is there. So this method is create the 3D CAD file in PAS. We can export into step format or parasolid format. This will help to take into the 3D printing format or ANSYS simulation or something, we can use it. Okay. Some of the projects we did it in our center. So like plastic industry, injection die molding industries and pattern making industries, they use this scanner to create the 3D CAD file. Some of them I'll show here. For the one of the customer from Coimbatore, they are producing automobile components. So like that, it's a scan data of the headlight glass, in the two-wheeler headlight glass. It's a complete scan data. You can see that it covers a whole point cloud, whole component. We'll get it in a point cloud manner. Then we'll develop this 3D CAD file. Next one is a headlight reflector. It has some complexity to get the data. Next one, we create a 3D CAD file from the point cloud data. This one is a head base of the headlight reflector assembly. It's a scan data of the component. Then from the point cloud data, we develop the 3D CAD file with the help of the Geomagic DesignX software. This one is a speedometer base. We'll, with the help of this Gamma scanner, we get the whole point cloud data of the component. Then we develop the 3D CAD file from the Geomagic software. It's one of the plastic injection molding die industry for the enclosure. It has some limitation. The rib dimension, the minimum wall thickness like 0.5 mm or 0.3 mm and minimum size holes will be there. With the help of this scanner, we get the whole point cloud data. From the point cloud data to develop the 3D CAD. It's one of the consumer goods of a dust pan. From the point cloud data to we develop the 3D CAD. This is also in plastic injection molding industry. For we scan the entire component. For the in case the customer want to create the CAD file in the dimension also, that time initially we'll scan the outer component. Next time we'll cut the component into two off. We'll scan the inner portion. Then we club all the point cloud data together. Then we'll get the whole point cloud data. From that we'll develop the 3D CAD file. Like that, the idea we develop this model. So initially we scan the outer dimension, outer body, then we cut the component into two off, then we scan the inner portion, then assemble together whole point cloud data. Finally, we developed the 3D CAD file. For this is one of the customer to develop the 3D CAD file for chair. So this is the idea to draw the curve. Then by using this curve to draw the surfaces, then the surface to patch it to create the 3D CAD file. We can export it to IGS format, the step format, or parasolid form. This one is for the over molding process for creating the gloves. It has tiny details like this kind of markers. So with the help of this Adams CAM scanner, we'll get the minute profiles also. From the point cloud data, we developed the 3D CAD file. Okay. Next, they'll take it into the over molding die or something. It's a injection molding industry for the shoe die, shoe bottom sole die. So with the help of this scanners too, we got all the minute details and fine features, everything. So it's highly helpful for the customer to get the whole point, whole data of the component. It's a bigger size component, like 1.5 meters, like this. It's a body cover for one machine. And this one is a automobile four-wheeler lower radiator grill component. One of the customer from Chennai. So we scan the entire grill portion in a day, and we developed the 3D CAD file with the help of the software. It's a Eritiga car rooftop component for one of the customer in Coimbatore. It's around length of around 2 meters something. We scan the entire car rooftop with the help of the scanner. And this is also one of the customer from Bangalore. We scan the entire automobile steering system to get the whole point cloud data for the inspection purpose. We use this scan. Okay. Next main advantage of application in 3D scanner is a 3D surface comparison. So from the, with the help of the 3D scanner, we can get the whole point cloud data of the component. This point cloud data mainly used for the re-engineering purpose. So we can produce 3D CAD file. Next main application is the 3D inspection purpose. We have a point cloud data, then we have the nominal data, the original data. We club together, we'll get the complete deviation mapping of the component. It's called the first article inspection. Based on the first article inspection report, they'll adjust the parameter or adjust the riser design, runner design, or feed design. They'll based on that, they'll eliminate the defects in the component. So next time onwards, they can get a good quality output. With help of like a CMM or a touch probe method scanner, we can measure only the particular dimension. The profile, in case the output component has shrinkage or warpage in your component, we can't measure with the CMM or we can't measure with the contact type of scanners. But using this kind of 3D scanner, we'll get the whole point cloud data. The point cloud data is a complete data of the component. So this point cloud data we merge with the original CAD file. We can measure the deviation mapping. In case shrinkage there, it will shows in a color. In case the warpage is there, it shows in a color. Sometimes the we can pick it over the component. We'll get the deviation. Also, we can measure it with the help of the GAM inspection software or geomagic control X software, whatever maybe we can use it. Okay. It's called a first article inspection. For the plastic injection molding die industry, they'll use this kind of activity to eliminate the wear and tear on the die. So sometimes the shrink marks are over the component. So they need to avoid the shrink marks or wear and tear of the component. So with the help of this 3D scanner too, we can get the whole point cloud data of the die, then merge with the original CAD file, then they'll get a whole car. Complete deformation report. That purpose they'll use it. So it's a highly accurate one and also fast one. We can quickly scan the entire component. We'll get the whole point cloud data, then merge with the original CAD file. We can say eliminate the time and we can eliminate the cost. We can eliminate the human error involvement. So it has more advantage with the help of using this 3D scanner with the 3D inspection application. Surface comparison on plastic parts is the main use for the eliminate the shrinkage and warpage in the injection molding output part, the first article part. Then next, based on the inspection report, they'll eliminate that problem. So it's highly helpful for the plastic and injection molding industries. We are getting the point cloud data from the comp with the help of the 3D scanner. We can merge with the original CAD file based on the principle, the method like 3-to-1 method or best fit method. We can align together. That is a one more advantage is so we can measure the material thickness also. In case varying the material thickness, we can measure with the help of the 3D scanner. And also the sink where the material accumulation, the whatever may be, we can measure with the help of the 3D inspection method. It's one small example of how the 3D inspection it will work. So in our center, we scan the entire component of the 3D printed part. Hello? So, we with the help of the 3D scanner to get the complete data of the physical component. Point cloud data merged with the original CAD file. The customer want to get the overall detail of the component. So, merged with the original CAD file. Normally, the people will do that CMM kind of inspection. This CMM kind of inspection only measure that the diameter or thickness or distance, height. But the curve profile, we can't measure with this kind of CMM kind of scanner. But by using this 3D scanner method, we can get the whole point cloud data, the whole curve profile, everything we can measure it. So alignment with the original CAD file using a method called 3-to-1 method or best fit method or something. So we can see the deviation mapping like that. So in case the color deviation mapping, the color chart will be there. In case the 1-to-1 matching, it will be in a green color. In case the more material will be there in the component, it will show us as a red color. Shrinkage warpage will be shown, we can identify in a blue color mark. And also we can pick it over the component with, we can measure the deviations also. So how much it did deviate from the original CAD file to the point cloud data. So based on that, they'll adjust it. Okay. The section, we can take a section in the software. We can measure the thickness also. And also we can get the idea of the inner side portion of the component also. We can get it. So, okay. material thickness also, how much material it will vary from original CAD file to the output part. So we can get the that kind of report also, we can get it. The 2D inspection, taking sections and draw the curves, then measure it with the help of the software, we can measure the dimension also, we can measure it. It's useful for the 2D inspection also, and also the 3D inspection. GD&T also possible with help of the 3D inspection method. From original CAD file to the output scan data, we can measure the GD&T, like cylindricity, circularity, whatever maybe, we can measure it. Some of the project we did it in our center, the major industry highly using this facility, like sand casting industries for their riser runner design optimization, and also for the injection molding industries for their based on the output, they'll reduce the shrinkage warpage in the output product using this facility to create eliminate that problem. So initially we will use the 3D scanner to create the get the output data in a point cloud format, then it's a original CAD file, then merge with the original CAD file to the point cloud data, we can measure the deviation. Based on the deviation report, we'll give it in a PDF format, various views, and it takes a number of sections, wherever they need a section, they'll give it in a section format. Based on the report, they adjust the parameter or a design, everything, they'll get a good quality output. Okay. It's a speedometer component, the whole assembly of the speedometer component. So it's a cartridge kind of component. So it has a minute details and very complicated details in the component. So with the help of the 3D scanner, we'll get the whole point cloud data of the component. Then the merge with the original CAD file, then we can measure the deviation. The one-to-one matching area is also there. Then also the shrinkage will be there in the component. So based on that, they'll adjust the die or something. Okay, you can see the scan data of the component and CAD file, then merging of the data. Then you can see the shrinkage area in a blue color. Okay. It has a minimum wall thickness and also the less rib area. So some deviation happened in the injection molding process. You can identify with the help of this 3D scanning process. It's an enclosure bag, scan data and the CAD file and the measurement report, deviation report, it's available in the system. This kind of minimum wall thickness component also possible with the help of the 3D scanning method. It's a complete assembly of the component. So initially we scanned with individual component, then we assemble together, then finally we scan that also. It's a front tail component. It has some shrinkage and warpage in the component. So based on that, they'll adjust the die and design everything. It's a comparison study of the conventional inspection with the 3D inspection. The conventional inspection, it's a very time consuming process. So it measures only at a particular time, it measures only one measurement at a time. So with the help of this scanner, we'll get the whole point cloud data. We can use it for 2D inspection or 3D inspection. We can efficiently measure the whole, we can study the whole component. So that is the main idea. And also it's some human error will be there. So it's not that much accurate one. So with the help of this 3D scanner, we'll get a good quality output and also high accurate output. We get it from a 3D scanner, then it's a high accurate one. And also it has some bottlenecks in the inspection process. So with the help of this 3D scanner, we can eliminate that. So with the help of the conventional method, we can measure only the particular dimensions only, particular profiles only. But this kind of 3D inspection, we can measure the, we can scan the internal components also, we can scan the outer dimension. So the whole point cloud data, we'll get it. The whole inspection, we can measure it. Whatever the shapes, complex shapes, organic shapes, bionic shapes, whatever the shapes is not a matter for this kind of scan. So it has some more advantages with the help of compared with the conventional inspection method. small video about the 3D scanning process. Projecting series of fringe pattern over the component, then the camera will capture the images. This camera, the sensor, it will convert the 2D images into the 3D point cloud data. Size is not a matter for this scanner. So small to medium, large size spots also we can scan with the help of this 3D scanner. The one-to-one matching, we can measure the deviations. We can export into the PDF format. Then the report will give the overall study of the component. Okay. In one of the center in PSG College of Technology, we have a handheld scanner also. This handheld scanner, it's a highly compact one. We can take it into any kind of environment. We can scan it for bigger size of object. In case the component size is more than 2 meter, 4 meter, we can easily scan it within 4 hours or something. So quickly we can scan it. It's a highly compact one. So any kind of environment we can take it. And also quickly we can scan the bigger size object. That is a main advantage of using this handheld scanner. Instead of projecting series of pattern, light source, it will project a line ray laser kind of technology. So it's a highly accurate one, and also it is a very compact one. Technical details of this scanner is measuring accuracy is 0.03 mm and also resolution is 0.05 mm. The scan speed is 480,000 scan per second. So we can scan the component quickly, and also we'll get the whole complete details of the component. Normally we use this kind of scanner for a bigger kind of objects. So that is the main advantage. And also it's a 4-line laser ray technology. So projecting a series of line rays for the component, then we'll get a point cloud data. The reflection images will capture the camera. Then this sensor will convert into the 2D images into the point cloud data. That's right. So it's a laser category is class 2 site. So normally we can use it for body scanner kind of application also. We can use this kind of 3D scanner. Non-contact with measurement solution like 3D scanner. Vary from structured light scanner to handheld scanner. This structured light scanner has some advantages and also some disadvantages. Handheld scanner has some advantages and disadvantages. So this structured light scanner is a portable one. We can compared to the CFM, it's highly accurate one and also fast one. So we can quickly get a complete detail of the component. From small object to medium level object, complex structures, anything we can scan it. But it's some disadvantages here. So in case structures like bigger size of turbine blade or bus or some aircrafts, it will take more time to scan the entire component. So patch, the field of view is limited. It's like 250 mm or 500 mm. So for the single shot, it will cover that particular area only. So it will take more time to cover the entire area. But using this handheld scanner, we can moving the hand over the component, we'll get the whole point cloud data of the component. So quickly we can scan the bigger size objects. But disadvantages in handheld scanner is the tiny details or minimum size of object we can't measure with this is handheld scanner. So that is the main disadvantage in the handheld scanner. But it's a very portable one. We can take it to wherever places, and also it's much flexible to scan the entire component. And also the main advantage in the handheld scanner is no need to spray over the component. Also very minimum level of reference marker is required in this component. So that is advantage in using handheld scanner. Okay. The scanning trends are normally useful for the reversioning from the point cloud data to 3D CAD file we can create, and also 3D inspection. It reduces the cost and also labor time. So high advantage one. And also we can quickly update the 3D CAD files from the starting from the scratch to taking more time to develop the 3D CAD. It eliminates that kind of problem. So it'll highly helpful. The one more topic is industrial 3D scanning technology. Normally the customer, some of the customer, they are asking this CT scanning method. This CT scanning method is in case the customer, they don't want to cut the component. They are coming with the whole assembly component. They want to get the whole complete CAD file of the component. At the time, by using this 3D scanner, 3D light scanner, we need to dismantle the component, or we need to cut the component to get the inner profile, or to get the inner details of the component. They are not accepting that kind of method. So for that, they are using the CT scanning method. It's normal like our medical CT scanning. So this using this CT scanners, inspection of part interiors without any harm or destruction of the component. No, it's a non-destructive technology. Without destructing the component, we will get the inner details of the component. That is the main advantage of using this 3D CT scan method. This CT scanning output in a form of in a series of images. Some of the softwares are available like 3D Doctor or something, Mimix or something. We can stack the entire images into the software. We can using the grayscale method to get the whole point cloud data in a 3D STL format. So this STL format, we can use it for the inspection purpose or 3D, creating the 3D CAD model purpose, whatever purpose we can use. With the help of the CT scanning, we can use that kind of application. The main advantage of using this CT scanning method, the internal structures of the object, we can get it with the help of, without destructing the component. It's a non-destructive method. It's and also it's a very accurate one. We'll get the internal details of the component, very accurate one. And also main advantage is to the internal defects also we can measure with the help of the CT scanning method. The porosity, wormhole, whatever size and shape of the defects also we can measure with the help of the CT scanning method. The void analysis, inspection, porosity, everything we can measure with the help of the CT scan method. But it's a costly one. That is the main problem. So it will take more cost to get the whole point cloud data and the whole details of the component. But we can use it for the various kind of purpose. That is this non-destructive 3D testing, we can use it for the internal defect analysis also, the assembly control, material structure analysis also, we can use it. Like this kind of internal details also we can get it with the help of the CT scanning method without destructing the component. That is the main other. And also the defects also we can measure it. The size and the shape of the defects also we can get it with the help of the CT scanning method. And the whole assembly component, without disturbing the component or without disturbing the assembly, we scan the entire component, we can get the whole detail, complete details of the inner profile. We can take the sections and we can draw the curve, then we, whatever the maybe, we can get it from the inspection report. That is the main method of using the CT scanning method. Sorry, the video is not playing in the system. Some problem. Some of the scanners available in the market, I'll show you. This is one of the scanner called Artex Space Spider 3D scanner. It's a highly portable one compared with the Prescan X7 scanner. It's a highly portable one. For the minimum size of component, we can use this kind of Artex Space Spider scanner to get the whole point cloud data. And also they have Artex Eva and Artex Eva light scanner for a bigger size component, and also for the body scanning method, we can use this kind of scanner to get the one. the one more scanner, they have this Arta Gray 3D scanner for they want to scan the entire building or entire structures for that kind of purpose. They are using we have Artex Ray 3D scanner in the market to scan the entire thing. The one more company called Hexagon Metrology, they are having scanner like absolute arm kind of scanner. So the various length of scanner available, 1 meter, 2 meter, 1.5 meter, 0.7 meter arm type scanners are available in the Hexagon 3D metrology scanner. And also they are having white light scanning method, white light scanner also available in the Hexagon metrology. It's a EC-TOM CT scanner from by RX Solutions. They have CT scanning scanner. One more scanner is Smart Scan by Hexagon Metrology. It's a two camera and one projector system scanner. The 3D system have one scanner called the Sense 2 scanner. It's for the body scanning method. They'll use this kind of scanner to get the whole body structure. And the Ferro, the one more company called Ferro, they're having Ferro arm scanner. It has a variable length kind of scanner. So these are the scanners available in the market to purchase, and we can get the service from the supplier to get the, in case if you want to create the 3D CAD file, or we want to update the existing CAD file, or we want to 3D inspect, whatever purpose we can use it. The main purpose using this 3D scanner to reduce the product development time. That is the main advantage. This 3D scanner, 3D structure light scanner, or 3D laser light scanner, or handheld scanner, CT scanner, it will, from the scratch, starting from the scratch, it will take more time and more costly. By using this kind of scanner, it's an advanced level of scanner. So by using this kind of technology to get the whole point cloud data, we can use it for various kind of applications like re-engineering, or 3D inspection, or 2D inspection, or sectional analysis, 3D, three-dimensional analysis, whatever purpose we can use it. Quickly, we can move into the next project, process, like editing the CAD file, or altering the design, or altering the pattern, or editing the die, or everything. Then the next day onwards, we can take into the process. That is the main advantage of using this kind of technology. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Any questions from audience?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, am I audible?
Audible, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Gunasilan, for your nice speech. You have an adequate facility at your institution or university. Okay,
yes,
so one thing I want to just mention here, that what is the accuracy level of this type of optical measurement, and what are the standards which we are following in the area of measurement?
With the help of this 3D scanner, sir?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. With help of the 3D scanning, we can get the accuracy level of 10 to 15 microns by using this scanner, sir. The output point cloud data has some limitation. It's 10 to 15 microns per feet or per meter. Then taking to the software like Geomagic, CATIA, or SolidWorks, the person who are involving in this process, re-engineering process, drawing the curves. So from 0.1 to 0.2 mm, we can vary, sir, from the point cloud data to the 3D CAD file.
Okay.
Yeah, so some of the methods available, sir. The auto surfacing methods are available in the software. So it will patch the surface, then it will give the 3D CAD file. It's a one-to-one accuracy. The under microns, the one on the under person, it will give the whole point cloud data into 3D CAD file. But we can't take it to the editing process, or we can't take into the die making process, or we can't take it that. But for that, we are using this 3D conversion by using the parametric modeling. We can take into the editing purpose. We can get a 3D CAD file.
One more question: what are the standards you are following in optical measurement?
Standards, no standards. Actually, what we are normally...
Because in the area of dimensional measurement, see, if you are using slip gauge, bore gauge, or maybe dial gauge, or maybe vernier, they are having some standard, Indian standard or international standard too. Likewise, is there any standard used in the optical measurement or not yet?
No, sir.
And how they are calibrated, basically?
Initially, we'll do the calibration before taking to the project, sir. We have some calibration table, then we'll...
Yes, calibration table is there, but how those particular tables are to be calibrated with?
From the supplier, they are giving this kind of calibration table, sir. Then we are measuring the whole... we are doing the calibration, then... frequently we are doing the calibration, then we are giving. You are asking about the output component, sir. Yes, sir. Initially the customer will give the component, sir. We'll scan the entire component, then we'll get the we'll create the 3D CAD file.
Yes, I agree with you that this particular technique is used for reverse engineering up to say 10 to 15 micron. This is valid. But is there any say standard, the optical standard they are followed? If yes, convey me those standard. If not, then it will be how the metrological people are believing in this type of technique.
After the customer will come and take the measurement with the help of the conventional tools, then they'll measure some of the dimension, they'll check the profiles, everything, then they'll take it, sir. Normally, we are not following any standards.
Yes. No, I am asking about the optical standard. See, related to GOM, you have said that you have scanner of GOM and the particular Renishaw. Okay. They are made certain equipment, that is optical equipment, with the help of some standard that has to be followed optically. See, you have a profile projector, and that profile projector is used for 2D measurement also. It is a shadow type of measurement, right? So it has certain standards, okay. In the same line of that standard, is there any standard available for such type of people, those who have manufactured the reverse engineering software? Got my point or no?
Hello,
got my point?
Hello, sir.
Yes, you are audible, sir.
No, sir, he's not. Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible. Please speak.
Hello, sir. Gunasilin, sir.
No, his voice is not getting.
Yes.
Is answering something, but
sir, actually what we'll do is frequently we'll do the calibration, sir, before taking the project. So like that,
please repeat your 4 to 5 sentences before you have talked. We are not getting your voice at that time, please.
Hello.
Yes, now you are audible.
Yes, sir. Right now we are not doing any kind of standards, sir. We'll do the calibration before taking the project, then we'll scan the component, then we'll do the 3D modeling purpose, then we'll finish the CAD file, then customer will come and check with the help of the conventional tool and everything, then one-to-one he'll measure some of the profiles, then measure the accuracy of the output, then they'll take it to the project. So like that we are doing right now. Then you are asking about the standard. Right now we are not using any kind of standard. We are not following any standards. I'll ask that to the customer.
Okay, sir, no problem. It is not like that. Just curiosity, I have asked the question.
Okay,
no doubt your service is good. But last question.
Yes, sir.
Can I ask you the last question?
Yes, sir.
Say there is a dimensional measurement, right? Yeah. You are inspecting some dimension with respect to certain standard, okay? That maybe you are using a reference standard as a slip gauge, okay? And they need to be calibrated again for certain, international standards, that are like PTB German, okay? So in line with that, is there any procedure of these particular devices to be calibrated for a certain reason?
Sir, we are following more than 21 steps, sir, for the calibration.
Yes.
It has some calibration table. I'll show you the calibration table.
I know the method of scanning. I have a certain demo at my institution too. Okay. But second, the last question? What is the accuracy of the Control X software? You are satisfied with that?
We are using a GAM inspection software, sir. We are not using the Geomagic Control X software. In our center, we have GAM.
GAM. Okay. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir, what about the cost of this? Shown that headlight of the two-wheeler, sir. What about the cost?
GAM ADAS 2M scanner, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, in our center, we bought it at 45 lakhs, sir.
That headlight?
Yes, sir. It's a blue light technology scanner. It's a 45 lakhs something. And also, we have a free scan X7 scanner. That is around 23 lakhs rupees.
Particularly that part, sir, I'm asking the part, how much cost to be headlight? You shown that in the PPT, sir.
Oh, that one, sir. Actually, it will take 1 or 2 hours to get the whole point cloud data. Then the inspection, it will take half days. So, per hour, we are charging for the scanning, we are charging 1,000 rupees, sir. Then 2,000, then the inspection, it will take around 4,000 to 6,000 rupees, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir. Thanks, sir.
Any questions? Okay. So the session was so nice, sir. I hope all the participants are enjoyed and understood the concepts very well. Thank you so much for sharing your knowledge. We are very grateful to you and took the time out of your busy schedule, sir. Thank you for your enlightening speech and enthusiastic participation.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
speaker, and thank you, organizer. You have nicely arranged this session.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thanks, sir.
Okay, sir. The next session will start at 11:45. Thank you, sir.
Thanks, sir. Thanks.